About the drug ecstasy. Next up.
I do not understand this. But I feel so.
I was starting to think you would make it today.
Hi, Father. I'm sorry I'm late.
Sister Marguerite's waiting in the laundry if you'd kindly help her there today.
The laundry?
Just some ironing, folding.
Starching a few collars.
Are you all right?
I'm fine. As fine as I look. But I'd be better if...
Are you out of your mind, Miss Garza?
Father, I'm sorry. I don't know what I'm saying. I don't know what's going on with me. Oh, my God. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Look, something's going on here.
Okay, slow down,
something
Jack.
Weird.
Just slow down. There's a perfectly good explanation. Okay?
What explanation, Rafe? This thing weighed a ton, and I threw it away like it was nothing.
Because you were worried about Allison. You've heard stories about people in really bad situations all of a sudden find the strength and everything that they had.
No, that's bull, and you know it.
Jack, hold on.
No, maybe Allison, I've been there. This whole vampire thing, the whole thing, I've been there. All the symptoms are coming back.
But how?
I don't know. Ask the expert. Look, all I'm saying is that if I'm having some kind of relapse, I'm sure Libby is too. And if she is, I'm afraid of what she might be going through and where I'm gonna find her.
When something's a little out of sight, it's even sexier, don't you think?
I can see you now.
Well, you've always seen right through me, sweetness.
Yeah, but why now? Like this? When I couldn't see you at all before.
Because my love for you is so intense. It's focusing all of my powers. Pulling everything together as it was. Desire is like a magnet.
Desire?
You're the reason I'm becoming real, Olivia. The reason you can see me. You're making me stronger. And when I'm strong enough, I'll have everything I want.
I'm fine. I just poked myself.
See.
No, I'm fine. What are you doing here?
I have to tell you something, but you have to promise me that you won't tell anyone.
Gabby, what? What
promise
is this all about?
Me. You have to promise.
I promise. I swear. What's the big secret?
I'm not feeling like myself anymore. It feels like they're coming back. The symptoms?
You mean...
Look, have you heard anything from anyone else who got bitten? Have you heard anything about them? Just tell me, Jamal. I have to know if they're feeling what I'm feeling. If they're going through this too, this the same thing I am. Hey, Ramsey!
Karen, hey, any requests?
Silence?
I don't know that one, but if you hum a few bars... I'm here all week. Try the Veep. Tip your waitress.
Okay, we're here to heal, doctor. Any louder and you won't be keeping the patients up. You'll be killing them.
Oh, fine. Whatever the pretty lady in the beautiful bathrobe wants, pretty lady gets.
What's going on, Chris?
Nothing.
What has gotten into you?
Nothing's gotten into me. I'm just happy.
No, you're not. You're peppy, and it's obnoxious and annoying, and it's a graveyard shift.
Well, nighttime is the right time.
For what?
Can you keep a secret?
No.
Okay, I'll tell you anyway. I just happen to be working on a project that will revolutionize life as we know it.
Okay.
Sorry I asked.
Oh, you don't believe?
What gave you that idea?
Karen, wait. No. You gotta keep this between us. I can't go into details, but let's just say that I happen to be in possession of something that...
What? Go on, something that what? Chris?
That's beautiful.
What?
Sorry, Karen, but I just now noticed how amazingly beautiful you really are.
Allison, are you all right?
Yeah, I just sort of hope that Jack finds Livy.
Don't worry, he will.
Yeah, I just wanted him to find her before something happens. I mean, you don't really know Livy like I do, and, you know, she's been through a lot, so I...
Well, your friend Livy's a lot stronger than you think. And
yeah.
So are you.
Yep. So is Jack. It's kind of what's gotten him so upset.
It's not exactly the kind of strength I meant.
You don't really think that he's right, do you? You don't think that his vampire symptoms are coming back.
I can tell you that there are no vampires here.
At least that's something, you know?
I wish there were more.
You know, we came here and we found what we were looking for. You know, take all the good luck we can get. I suppose that, you know, now, since we know, we can head back to town, I guess.
Not quite yet, if that's okay.
Why? Is there something wrong?
No, not really. I just think, you know, we should rest a little more before you start driving again.
No, I feel really good. Isn't that weird?
I'd say lucky.
So you guys really thought that I was hurt, huh?
I'm glad we were wrong.
Yeah. Me too. Way wrong.
Hey. Is something bothering you?
You know, just that I don't remember getting hurt. Don't you think that's a little strange?
Well, that's a good thing, right?
Well, yeah, no, it's a really good thing. I mean, I wouldn't mind feeling like that every time I woke up.
Like what?
I mean, it was the most amazing feeling. I mean, I woke up and I sort of felt like almost drunk or something. You know, I wasn't like, didn't have the woozy part or anything. I just, you know, the really, really happy part. Kind of like I was, you know, floating on a cloud or something. I mean, I just never felt that sort of, like...
What?
Like peacefulness, you know? I mean, I still sort of feel it all the way down to my toes. You know, like it's like, I feel like the world is just so beautiful and almost perfect.
Well, sounds like a wonderful thing.
Yeah.
Hold that feeling tight, Allison. They don't come along every day. They're miracles, really. Small ones.
No, yeah, that's like a miracle feeling. That's exactly what it was. It is. Was.
It is.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. Okay. So, now that we have that established, I guess we should just go then.
Yeah, we should. You lead the way. I'll follow if I can keep up.
Yeah, well, I'll try and slow my cloud down.
Thank you.
don't forget your flashlight.
Got it. Whoa. Hold that feeling tight, Allison.
A dream. Okay, I'm gonna wake up any minute. This can't be real. It can't be.
It feels real enough. Doesn't it, sweetness?
Yes. But I knew it. You're not. If I can't touch you, then...
But you can feel me. You can feel my breath on you right now, can't you? I'm alive and inside every vein. In your mind, awake and asleep. In the depths of your heart, I'm there.
Yes.
When all is right, and in its place, we'll be together.
But how?
Tear by tear. As the lives of those who challenge me fall apart. And as their happiness dies and the power of their imperfect love fades, my power grows. My life grows.
No, but love never fades. True love is forever.
That's the lie, sweetheart. A fairy tale told to children. I've told you, human love is a fragile, brittle thing, easy to break. This thing you have with Jack, it's nothing.
No, that's not true.
Only my love is forever. Human love has boundaries. My love can go on and on and on. Endless, like the night. And I'll prove it to you.
Prove?
You'll return to me willingly when I return. And then you'll know the meaning of everlasting love. When you'll reach out your cold hand to touch me. And I'll be there. And when that day comes, I'll hold you close. I vow it to you. Sweet Olivia, the next time we meet, you'll see more of me. But until then,
what happened? What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong.
You came very close to getting my knee into you. What were you thinking?
I wasn't really. I guess. I've just been too jazzed about all this research to think about anything other than accepting awards, doing interviews, you know?
Interviews?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you see, it's all out there waiting for me. It's just a matter of time, really. Dr. Christopher Ramsey, 21st century Einstein, Schweitzer, and Pasteur all rolled into one. And I'm sorry for everyone who doesn't feel the way I do. I'm telling you, I'm the king of the world!
Okay, I've got news for you, King. I think you should check in the mirror because you're still the same old Chris that you always are, okay? Just acting more like a jerk, but that's all.
You're wrong, Karen. Something's changed. I don't know what it is, but I'm not going back. No way.
Are you sure you don't want to stop by at the clinic? I mean, I know you're fine,
no,
but just a quick checkup, just to
I'm
be
fine.
Sure.
Please, stop. I'm fine. Okay, let's not talk about me anymore. Let's talk about you. Tell me everything.
There's not much to tell.
Oh, no? Right, you're just like this nice vampire slayer from transatlantic Transylvania.
It's not as exotic as it sounds. It's the family business. I'm really just a boring workaholic kind of guy.
We hold back, Rafe.
What makes you think I'm holding back?
Well, you know, maybe I have special powers too. I can tell when someone is holding back something from me.
Like your boyfriend?
Jamal? Yeah, no.
Lots of guys do.
Yeah, well, not my guy. You know, Jamal knows me and I know him. You know, it's that whole sort of thing. You're gonna totally love him. I can't wait for you to meet him.
Yeah, me too. Sounds nice.
Yeah. He's the best. And I am so totally in love with him.
Then he's a lucky guy. A very lucky guy.
Here you go.
Thanks. I don't need to be any jumpier than I already am.
So what makes you think these symptoms are coming back?
I came on to a priest.
What?
Nothing serious, no hands or anything.
Oh, thank God. Sorry, go ahead.
Well, I would have been a lot sorrier if the priest hadn't embarrassed me before I got all...
Built up some steam, huh?
Yeah, well, it was pretty steamy from my end, believe me. Jamal, I couldn't stop myself.
Well, you know, men in uniform. Not a big deal.
Jamal, this is not a joke. Why do you think this is happening to me? What does this mean?
Look, just take it easy, okay? You're not the only one that's backsliding. Kevin was talking about the reason why he thinks that everyone is going through these feelings and urges is because, what was he saying? Some kind of a psychological flashback. Like some kind of slime that Caleb leaves behind, like a snake or something.
Well, you have to promise me you will not tell anyone what I did.
I promise. But why especially not Allison?
Because she already doesn't like me or trust me.
She's just overprotective.
Yeah, well, she's a little too overprotective, if you ask me.
Yeah, well, I didn't.
Look, I'm your sister, and I can speak my mind if I want to.
Well, you know, I can speak my mind, too. Look, Gabby, look, I know you want to be a part of my life, and I want it, too. But somehow, you better start figuring out a way to get along with Allison, because she's not going anywhere. Okay, no matter what you think.
Oh, man. What's going on here, Livy?
Jack.
What's going on? What are you doing?
You'll always love me. You'll never let me go. Promise me, Jack. Just hold me closer, please. Promise me.
Hey, I promise. Let's get you out of here. Where are your clothes at, huh? Wait, Libby, where?
I don't know. Jack, I don't,
Okay, that doesn't matter, right? Look, hey, I'm gonna get you home. All right?
Yes, home, please.
Gotcha. Why did you come here in the first place?
I don't remember.
Well, you have to think. Tell me.
Jack. Look, it doesn't matter. Look at me right now, Jack. Promise me you always love me, please. Hey, promise.
Of course
me.
I
say it, Jack.
Yes,
always.
Yes, I promise. All right, what makes you think I wouldn't?
I don't know. I'm just afraid. I'm afraid that our love won't last.
That's crazy.
Promise me.
Hey, I promise. Okay? Let's go. Everything's changed, Chris. You've waited your whole life to feel this way. Now the world is yours. It's red, it's ripe, and it's ready for the taking. Anything's possible. Nothing can stand in your way.
Sister, now you got no right to be dissing Allison like that.
Right or not, Jamal, it's time for you to take a big step back and see that spoiled rich white girl for who she is. She's not one of us.
Yeah, but you've only been one of us for like 10 minutes.
No, Jamal, I have been a woman of color my entire life. I'm just trying to make sense out of my life now and who I am now.
You're the same person you've always been. I'm the same, Allie's the same, we're all good, honest, caring people, okay? And I happen to be in love with her.
She doesn't know you, Jamal.
She knows everything about me.
Does she know you slept with Valerie?
You what? I don't know where my clothes are or how I got here. I just don't know.
Well, you must have wanted in there pretty bad.
But Jack, I didn't do that.
Are you sure? Because this is how I found it when I got here.
Yes, I'm sure. Jack, I mean, this would have taken somebody with incredible strength to do something like that.
Yeah. Yeah, it would have taken incredible strength.
The last thing I remember is leaving Eve's to go home, and after that, how I got here and where my clothes are, it's just all a blank. It's like...
It's like what?
Like it's a dream or something. Like it was a... God, I don't know. I'm not making any sense right now.
No. You're wrong. You're making a lot of sense, Lily. A lot. And I don't like the sound of it. One little bit.
Stay tuned for scenes from the next Port Charles, Tempted.
On the next Port Charles.
Joe's met someone else, hasn't he?
You told me that this was from a customer. Why didn't you tell me that it was a gift from Valerie?
I just need to know if Ian is a threat to Eve.
In Pine Valley, it's all about Erica Kane and her world. On SoapNet, it's all about you. Coming up next is All My Children on SoapNet, devoted to soaps and you.
Up next, it's All My Children, followed by One Life to Live and General Hospital, right here on SoapNet.
Well, we're here
because I